Last class. Good morning, students. Today we are discussing about properties of determinant. In last class, we discussed the expansion of third order determinant. The expansion of third order determinant means the product of the elements of the sum of the product of the elements of any row or column with their corresponding cofactor is known as the determinant of A. Now let A is equal to, this is A11, A12, A13, A21, A22, A23, A31, A32, A3. Is a matrix, is a matrix of 3×3. So determinant of A is equal to, this is A11, A12, A13. This is A21, A22, A23, A31, A32, A33 is equal to A11 into C11 plus A12 into C12 plus A13 into C13. And so on. This is according to expansion, according to row 1. A1 with corresponding cofactor plus A12 with corresponding cofactor, that is C12. Plus A13 into corresponding cofactor C13. Sum of the product of the elements of any row or column with their corresponding cofactor is equal to value of the determinant. Now, sum of the sum of the product. Elements of any row or column with corresponding cofactor of cofactors of other row or column is equal to 0. Sum of the product of the elements of any row or column with corresponding cofactor of other row or column is equal to 0. That is A11 into cofactor of this is first row, cofactor of second row or third row. C21, A11 into C21 plus A12 into C22, A12 into C22 plus A13 into C23 is equal to 0. A1 elements of first row, but cofactor of second row. Elements of first row and cofactor of second row. Product of the elements of first row and cofactor of second row, their sum is 0. Or A11 into C31 plus A12 into C32 plus A13 into C33 is equal to 0. Or A11 into C12 C12 plus A21 into C22 plus A31 into C3 is equal to 0. Or A13 into C11 plus A23 into C21 plus A33 into C31 is equal to 0. Means sum of the elements of the sum of the elements of any row or column. This is third column. This one third A13 C A23 A33 A13 A23 A33. These are the elements of third column. But C11 C21 C31, these are the cofactor of first column. So product of the elements of third column with product with cofactor of first column, their sum is equal to 0. Their sum is equal to 0. Example here A11 into what is C21? What is C21? C21 means C21. C21 means cofactor of second row first row. Example A is equal to determinant of 3, 5, 1, 0, 2, 6, 9, 8, 7. So 3 into 3, A11 into C12 plus A21 into C22 plus A31 into C32 is equal to A11 is 3 into C12 minus 1 to power 1 plus 2. Determinant of eliminating first row and second column, first row and second column. So 0, 6, 9, 7 plus A21 is 0. 0 into minus 1 to power 2 plus 2. C22 means 2 plus 2. Determinant of this is second row, eliminating second row and second column. Eliminating second row and second column means 3197 plus A31 means 9 minus 1 to power 3 plus 2 into eliminating the elements of third row and second column. So 3106 is equal to 3 into this is minus 1 to power 3 means minus 1. This is 0 minus 54. This is 0. This one 0. Plus 9 into this is minus 1. This is 8 minus 0. 18 minus 0. Is equal to minus 3 into minus 54. This is minus 9 into 18. Or 3, 4, the 12, 2, 3, 5, 15, 16, 162, minus 7, 2, 2, 7, 62 is equal to 0. So sum of the product of the elements of any row with corresponding cofactor of other row or column is equal to 0. A is equal to A11, A12, A13, A31, A32, A33 is A matrix of order 3, then what is the value of A11 into C11 plus lambda times C12 plus mu times C13 plus A22 into C21 plus A21, C12, A13, A21, A22. Then what is the value of A11, C11 plus lambda into C21 plus mu into C31 plus A12 into C12 plus lambda times C22 plus mu times C32 plus A13 into C13 plus lambda times C32 plus mu times C33. For council exam, CHSE exam, 1 marks. What is the value of this? Solution. A11 into C11 plus lambda times C21 plus mu times C31 plus A12 into C12 plus lambda times C22 plus mu times C32 plus A13 C13 plus lambda times C32 plus mu times C33 is equal to A11 C11 plus lambda into A11 C21 plus mu into A11 C31 plus A12 C12 plus lambda into A12 C22 plus mu into A12 C32 plus A13 C13 plus lambda into A12 C32 plus mu into A13 C32 plus A13 C33 is equal to A11 C11 plus A11 C11 plus A12 C12 plus A13 C13 plus lambda times lambda technical common lambda into A11 C21 plus lambda into lambda technical common A12 C22 plus is also A13 C32 plus mu is taking common mu into A13 C31 plus A12 C32 plus A13 C33 is equal to this is A11 C11 plus A12 C12 plus A13 C13 is equal to value of the determinant. This is the value of the determinant because sum of the product of the elements of any row with corresponding row vector is equal to value of the determinant. This is the determinant of A. This is determinant of A plus lambda times lambda times is 0 because A11 into C21 plus A12 into C2 plus A13 into C23 is equal to A13 into C23 C23 is equal to 0. Plus mu into A11 into C31 plus A12 into C32 plus A13 into C33 is also 0. because some are the product of the elements of any row with corresponding cofactor of other row. Elements of some are the product of the elements of any row or column with corresponding cofactor of other row or column is equal to 0. This one is 0. This value approaches to 0. This value also approaches to 0. So this is equal to determinant of A. Next, properties of determinant. Properties of determinant. Property 1, if the elements are rows or columns, if the elements of rows or columns are interchangeable, then value of the determinant remains unchanged. That is, determinant of A is equal to determinant of A transpose. And symbolically we can write CI double implies RI double implies CI. That is, determinant of A is equal to, suppose A11, A12, A13, A21, A22, A23, A31, A32, A33. Then determinant of A transpose is equal to, first row becomes first column. Taking first row becomes first column. A11, A12, A13. Second row becomes second column. A21, A22, A23. Third row becomes third column. A31, A32, A33. So both determinant of A and determinant of A transpose, both the answer same. A11, A12, A13, row becomes column. So R1 becomes C1, R2 becomes C2, R3 becomes C3. Then the value, both the values are equal. This is property 1. If the elements of rows or columns are interchanged, first row becomes column, first column. Second row becomes second column. Third row becomes third column. Then value of the determinant is equal to value of transpose of the determinant. Means A transpose determinant. Determinant of A is equal to A transpose. This is property 1. Next, property 2. If the elements of two columns are interchangeable, then the numerical value of the determinant remains same, but sign changes. Sign changes. And symbolically, symbolically C I double implies C J or R I double implies R J. Let determinant of A is equal to A11, A12, A13, A21, A22, A23, A31, A32, A33. Then suppose R1 double implies R2. R1 double implies R2 means row 1, the element of row 1 goes to row 2 and the element of row 2 goes to row 1 is equal to minus 1 times A21, A22, A23, A21, A22, A23. These are the element of row 2. Goes to row 1. And this is one A11, A12, A13. A31, A32, A33. The value of the determinants numeric value will become same, but sign changes. Sign changes. R1 double implies R2 means elements of row 1 goes to row 2 and elements of row 2 goes to row 1. Then sign changes, but numeric value will remain same. Numeric value will remain same. Similarly, suppose C1 double implies C3. C1 double implies C3. C1 means these are the C1. This is C1. This is C3. C3, the elements of C3 goes to C1 and the elements of C1 goes to C3. So this is equal to again minus 1 into C13, C23, C33. But column to A13, A23, A33, A12, A22, A3, A11, A21, A31. Minus 1 and so two rows, the elements are two rows or two columns are interchanged, sign changes, but numerical remains same. This is property 2. Next. Property 3. If all the elements of a row bracket rate or a column are 0, then the value of the determinant is 0. That is, this is A11, A12, 0. A21, A22, 0. A31, A32, 0. All the elements of A row or A column, this is a column. All the elements of a column, third column, all the elements of third column are 0. Then value of the determinant is 0. Of example 0, 5, 1, 0, 2, 6, 0, 9, -10 is equal to 0 because C1 approaches to what? 0. Column 1 approaches to 0. Next, property 4. If the elements of two rows or two columns are proportional proportional or identical then value of the determinant is zero and value of determinant is zero that is determinant of A is equal to A11, A12, A13, A21, A22, A23, A21, A22, A23, row 2 and row 3, row 2 is equal to row 3, row 2 is equal to row 3, A21, A21, A22, A22, A23, A23, is equal to 0, expand. Expand to row 1 becomes what? 0. So elements of row 2 and elements of row 3 are equal. Then the value of the determinant is 0. So if the elements of 2 rows or 2 columns are proportional or identical, then value of the determinant is 0. Example, suppose 2, 3, 5, minus 1, 4, 6, this is 6, 9, 15, 6, 9, 15, 2, 3, 4, column 1 is 2, 3, 5, column 1, 2, 3, 5, column 3, 6, 9, 15, so 2 into 3, 6, 3 into 3, 9, 5 into 3, 15, this means column 1 and column 3 are proportional. So the value of determinant is 0. So expand this. This is equal to 2 into. This is taking 2 into cofactor of 2. Cofactor of 2 means this is 60. 60 minus 54 minus 1 minus 1 plus minus this is the sign means cofactor of first row first column is plus then minus then plus and so on so minus 1 into 15, 45 minus 45. Next, plus 6 into 18. Minus 20 is equal to 2 into minus 6 plus 1 into 0 plus 6 into minus 2. So 12 plus 0 minus 12 is equal to 0. Since column 1 and column 3 are proportional. That is C3 is equal to 3 times C1. Hence determinant is 0. And determinant of A is 0. Determinant of A is equal to 0. This is the property 4. Next, property 5. If the elements of any row or column, if all the elements of any row or column is multiplied by SLR K, then the value of the new determinant multiplied by SLR K, the elements of any row or column of the determinant, it multiplied by SLR K, then value of new determinant is k times the value of original determinant. That is, let determinant of A is equal to A11, A12, A13, A21, A22, A23, A31, A32, A33. Now, K into A11, K into A21, K into A31, A12, A13, A22, A23, A31, A32, A33. The elements of first column of the determinant, is multiplied by K. Then we can taking K as a column from column 1, A11, A12, A13, A21, A22, A23, A31, A32, A33 is equal to K into determinant of A. Also we can multiply K with the elements of other row or other column. That means we can write also A11, A12, A13, K is multiplied with the elements of second row. A21 K times A22 K times A23 A31 A32 A33. So we can take a common from the elements of row or column, or K is multiplied with the elements of either a row or a column. Example, let determinant of A. Determinant of A is equal to 3, 5, 1, 0, 2, 6, 1, 1, 5, 5. So what is the value of determinant? 3 into sign plus minus plus. So 3 into, so put a positive sign before 3. 3 into cofactor of 3. Cofactor of 3 means this is 10. 10 minus 6. Next minus 5 into 5. 0. 0 minus 6. Plus 1 into 0 minus 2. 0 minus 2. This is 3 into 4 minus 5 into minus 6 plus 1 into minus 2. That is 12 plus 30 minus 2 is equal to 40. Now 5 into determinant of A. 5 into 10 means 5 into 3 5 1 0 2 6 1 1 5 so 5 is multiplied with either a row multiplied with the elements of either a row or a column either a row or a column 5 is multiplied with the elements of only one row or elements of only one column so 5 is multiplied with 3 5 is multiplied with 3 it becomes 15 5 multiplied with 0 it is 0 5 multiplied with 1 it is 5 means 5 is multiplied with column 1 and column 2 column 3 remain same 5 2 1 1 6 5 what is the value this is 15 into 10 10 minus 6 10 minus 6 minus 5 into minus 5 plus minus plus minus 5 into minus 5 into 0 minus 30 0 minus 30 plus 1 into 0 sorry 0 minus 10 0 minus 10 is equal to 15 into this is 4 minus 5 into minus 30 this is 1 into minus 10 equals 60 this is 150 this is minus 10 it becomes 200 200 is equal to 5 into 40 that means 5 into determinant of a 5 into determinant of determinant is 40 so 5 into 40 is equal to 200 this is the property 5